Good evening. A year after COVID-19 cancelled traditional Anzac Day commemorations, thousands of our veterans have answered the call to march in the city on a glorious autumn day. More than 100,000 Australians have died in war, and today they were remembered.
A dawn service that's hard to top. The Harbour Bridge this morning, early.
We dedicate ourselves to the cause of justice, freedom and peace, and for the wisdom and strength to build a better world.
And it seemed like the bugler was playing for the entire city. Down below, the city was stirring. The Anzac Day March, cancelled last year, was back with a spring in its step. 4,000 marchers calling Elizabeth Street their own. It was just a kilometre, but 100-year-old Dennis Davis wanted more.
A bit too short.
Too short?
Too short, definitely too short.
He trains for the day.
I walk on 4Ks every morning before breakfast.
Oh, this is just a walk in the park.
That's for sure, that's for sure.
Two dozen or so World War II veterans and everyone with a story to tell. 94-year-old Margaret Ferrier.
I was a flight mechanic.
Yes.
On Tiger Boss.
Living history, men and women from battles won and lost.
Oh, I'm only 94.
You're only 94.
I'd be one of the young ones.
One of the young ones.
A beaming Iris Terry. She's 103. She served at Richmond Air Base during the war. This was her first march.
She never knew that she could march. Nobody ever asked her, so she didn't know she could go in the march.
My goodness, that's incredible.
And then there's Joe McGrath. He's barely missed a march since the end of World War II.
What did being in the march mean for you today?
Oh, everything. I've been here 60 years. I've been coming here.
For 2 hours, the crowd was taken to another place in time. So too for 99-year-old former airman Ron Leckie.
You transgress yourself. You're another person altogether. You think of where you were. It's good.
A fighter jet fly past, bringing them back to reality.
Numbers might be down on previous years, but what amazes you when you talk to some of these veterans is just how determined so many of them are to be here today.
Case in point, 97-year-old Walter Tuchin leading his dive bomber squadron.
You're in hospital this morning.
Yeah, my nurse has brought me here.
You didn't want to miss it?
No.
What's it mean to you?
Everything.
They made an effort and it was appreciated.
And to see some of those people stand and they're in their wheelchairs and they want to walk that last way is so special. And you just feel grateful for what they've done for their country.
She could have been talking about Alf Carpenter.
Not half as good as other years, but it's still okay.
Alf is 104.
That cheer is for you.
Hooray! I better give a wave.
And they cheered the oldest soldier on duty today, New Guinea veteran, 105-year-old Albert Collins.
All these gentlemen, that thorough gentleman who served in for helping for Australia to be what it is, I'm very proud of every one of them.
It was a more sombre service this morning at the Cenotaph in Martin Place. 1,000 or so attending.
We are pleased to welcome you all back to Martin Place for the 2021 Anzac Day Dawn Service.
A 94-year-old tradition was restored.
They shall grow not old, as we who are left grow old.
It's great coming to finally be able to come to a service, considering other states around the country are still locked down at home because of COVID.
And with COVID in retreat, it was a great day for a spontaneous hug. And when you're a 99-year-old Col Moyer, it's something to sing about.
Here's a good old whiskey, but she's very frisky. Bob it down, bob it down. One more. Here's a good old rum. Gives you a lot of fun. Mop it down, mop it down.
Mark Burrows, Nine News.
With COVID-safe restrictions in place for the big Anzac Day events, many Sydneysiders have opted for smaller commemorations. It's also an indication that people aren't willing to let go of what's become more meaningful after the special lockdown moments of the day last year.
A new tradition continuing for the Anzac Dawn. In the blue early morning light at Erskineville, they lined the street to pay their respects. Last year's COVID driveway ceremonies seem here to stay. From an apartment block in Chatswood to a cul-de-sac in Abbotsbury. Candles flickering in driveways as many Sydneysiders once again chose to light up the dawn from home. With limited numbers, official dawn services were back across our suburbs. At Parramatta, bagpipes heralded sunrise. A minute's silence held in the shadow of a digger.
Lest we forget.
At St Mary's RSL, their normal dawn service crowd of 6,000 was reduced to 500, rugged up against the cold in the car park. Among them, Deontay Barnes, wearing her late father's medals from his service in Afghanistan.
It felt really good because in 2019, I promised my dad I'd go to the Anzac dawn service with him, but he didn't make it until the 25th.
There was no beach service at DY this year. Instead, returned servicemen and women and their families gathered around the eternal flame at the RSL and placed poppies for remembrance.
Although things look a little different to our annual DY beach service, we are thankful we are able to bring the community together again.
A taxi convoy waiting at the RSL Anzac Village in Narrabeen to ferry elderly residents into the city for this year's official march. A minute's silence held across Sydney. Helmets off for firefighters at Darlinghurst. A ring of candles in a park at Erskineville. A solemn line of early risers gathered across the green at the Camden RSL's memorial. Their Anzac Day march, one of only a handful to go ahead, with all attendees pre-booking their spot. A steady stream of school children laying wreaths and paying their respects.
With some COVID restrictions still in place, the RSL has actively encouraged Sydneysiders to stay local this year. It's a way of commemorating Anzac Day, which may continue for years to come.
As long as they're remembering, it doesn't matter where you remember, that's the whole purpose of today.
Laura Tunstall, Nine News.
For World War II veteran Richard Wilson, affectionately known as Dickie, a little health setback stopped him from marching in the city this year. So his family put on a ceremony in his front yard at Carlingford.
Jacket ready. Tie on. When you can't go to the march,
pretty flash.
The march can go to you. 96-year-old Dickie Wilson on a short walk to the front yard of the home he built with his own hands in Carlingford 60 years ago. Standing to attention. Just as he did when he turned 21 on the front line. He'll miss the city tradition this year, but his family wouldn't let him miss out. All 15 of Dickie's great-grandchildren with sprigs of rosemary, handwritten cards and notes, a simple thank you.
With golden soil and wealth atop.
2020 was the year of keeping distance from precious grandparents. Today, not so. A handshake from 11-year-old Liam, who knows just how important that is. Dickie is the only one of the mates he served with left. He was deployed to New Guinea and pictured here in Borneo. Some of these men didn't live long past this photograph.
Did you know what you were going into?
Well, you trained, but you didn't realise until you got into action. You know, when bombs are dropping and there's blokes getting killed everywhere, that you suddenly realise that you might be a lucky one and get through it.
We first met Dickie 2 years ago when, in his own tradition, he skipped the march halfway through when he spotted his family, but always thinking of his mates.
About all the fellas didn't make it. Sorry.
But they'd be so proud of you, sir. And look at all these beautiful faces that have come to see you. Yeah. Well done. We're all so proud of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Dickie had a small heart attack in the lead up to today, so he wasn't quite up to marching this year.
I heard you had a bit of a turn a few weeks ago. Yeah. Are you okay?
Oh, yes.
You feeling good?
Just poking along.
And while he's seen the horrors of war, he knows he's one of the lucky ones.
But I can't complain, Elizabeth. Yeah, no, I've had a good life. I'm happy.
Lizzie Pearl, Nine News.